So I'm going to talk a little bit about how SketchUp geo-references models and also the benefit you have once you do that. And so this is a fresh SketchUp file. And if I go to Window Model Information, I don't actually know where that site location is. The way you would normally add a location out in SketchUp is to click Add Location, and then you type in an address or just some. You can it can be Union Station in Denver, but actually I'm going to pick 18th and Champa. So I'm picking a street intersection in downtown Denver. I just happen to know some buildings around there, so that will make this demonstration easier. So it's using Google Maps as the API. I'm zoomed in a little farther than I want to be. I'm going to go back a bit here. My internet connection is just a bit slow for this. So I'm going to select a region, and then this little crosshair actually is going to be the origin for my model. So I'm going to put my model origin right there. And when I click grab, SketchUp goes and adds that content into my model. And there's actually a toolbar called the Google toolbar. And I'm going to move that actually down here. So it's a pretty subtle change right now because our ground is flat, but you can actually toggle terrain on and off. There are times you may want it to be flat. So now I have a model that exists at a particular place, and Energy Plus can use that location for the shadow calculations. So what else can you do? Well, what if I want to have shadows of some of these other buildings here? Because I'm geo-referenced, I can now actually link to Google Earth content or 3D warehouse content. So I'm going to go to components. And this is where you would grab, if I look for, you might grab chairs or people or equipment, and it links to 3D warehouse. So you can drop in things you want. What I want to look for is actually nearby models. And so this takes my location, and then it will load up models that are close to where I am. So let's see, what's one that we can pick here? Okay, this building here is actually going to be this. So when I click here, that'll open the 3D warehouse window. What I actually want to do is click on the icon itself, and it will directly load the model in. Some of these models are really small, some are large. It depends how they were modeled. Some of them were modeled using SketchUp and then uploaded through to 3D Warehouse. Some of them were modeled using a new tool called Building Maker, which is a web-based program that uses aerial photography to model buildings, and I'll discuss that in a separate tutorial. But basically, I just wanted to show that this content can be loaded in here. I'm going to load in another adjacent building or group of buildings in this case. That should be in here soon. Okay, yeah, so here's my site, and so now I have a lot of context around there. So I have this adjacent context in, but I don't want all this in Energy Plus. So what I can do is I can go in and select a group of faces or just individual faces. Let's just do this one for now, and I can copy that. And then I can make an Energy Plus open or an OpenStudio shading group. Click an insertion point for that, paste in place. And if I hide this now, I have a single surface as a shading group, which will make things a lot easier to get your existing context. So basically, that's all there is to the geo-referencing. You can also turn on shadows and cast shadows directly from these if you want to do a quick analysis of what times of year or times of day your building's going to be impacted by the adjacent context.